bell button.
In this video, we are going to see about response of a first order system for unit step input signal. Going to see about first order system. The closed loop system with unity feedback is, so this is the first order closed loop system. So this is the system gain of first order system. This is the feedback. So we already know how to reduce the feedback. We know this is input, this is output, this is system gain, this is feedback gain. So here this is system gain, this is feedback. Here feedback gain is 1. Therefore, C of S divided by R of S equal to G of S value equal to 1 by Ts divided by 1 plus, again G of S is equal to 1 plus Ts into, here feedback gain is unity, therefore 1. Therefore, 1 divided by T of S divided by, so we can take LCM for this, so it will become Ts plus 1 divided by Ts. So both will get cancel each other. Finally, we will have 1 by 1 plus Ts is the transfer function of first order system. So now, the standard form of closed loop transfer function of a first order system is C of S divided by R of S. The transfer function of first order system equal to 1 by 1 plus S into T. So now, the response or output, this is the Laplace transform of output, this is the Laplace transform of input. Therefore, from this, now response or output C of S equal to R of S into transfer function 1 by 1 plus ST. So now, according to the concept, so we have to substitute unit step input signal as an input. So further, C of S equal to, so now unit step, so we know time response of unit step is 1. So now here input is in terms of Laplace transform. So now Laplace transform for 1 is 1 by S. Therefore, R of S equal to 1 by S into 1 plus S into T. So now, according to the concept, the response of a first order system for unit step input signal. So now this is the response, but it is in terms of S domain. So we have to convert this into time domain. So for that, first we have to rearrange it into standard form to take Laplace inverse transform in order to get C of S into C of T. So now we have to rearrange this. So suppose if this is a pole which is on the origin, but its structure is not a pole. So we have to first arrange like a pole. It means we have to arrange this term as a S plus term. Therefore, further this can be written as, so we have to arrange S plus term, we have to take coefficient of S outside. So coefficient of S is T. Therefore, we have to take T outside. So you will get 1 by S into T into S plus 1 by T. So now we can write that as C of S equal to 1 by S into 1 by T divided by S plus 1 by T. So now we can say it is like a 1 by T divided by S into S plus 1 constant term. So now we can apply partial fraction. So we know the partial fraction concept. Here there are two separate poles. So we have to apply A divided by S for first pole. Next, B divided by second pole. S plus 1 by T. According to the partial fraction concept, we can calculate A equal to T of S into its denominator value is S and the denominator part S. So we have to multiply with denominator part. Then we have to substitute S value. Here S value equal to 0. So now A equal to C of S into S. Then S equal to 0 we have to substitute. So C of S equal to this, 1 by T divided by S into S plus 1 by T into S equal to 0. So both s will get cancelled each other. If we substitute s equal to 0 here, 1 by t divided by 1 by t. Therefore, a equal to 1. Similarly, b equal to c of s into b's numerator part is this one. Therefore, s plus 1 by t. Now, yes, what is the s value? Here, s plus 1 by t equal to 0. Therefore, s equal to minus 1 by t. Therefore, b equal to c of s. This is the c of s 1 by t divided by s into s plus 1 by t into s plus 1 by t. Then we have to substitute s equal to minus 1 by t. So this term and this term will get cancel each other. If we substitute minus 1 by t for s, we will get b equal to minus 1. Then, so next, we have to substitute into c of s. So c of s equal to, what is the a value? A value equal to 1. Therefore, 1 by s minus 1 by s plus, but b value equal to minus 1. Therefore, minus 1 divided by s plus 1 by t. So now we got standard form. In order to get c of t value, we have to take Laplace inverse transform for s domain system. Therefore, c of t equal to Laplace inverse of c of s. So c of s equal to, now we have to apply Laplace transform for 1 by s minus 1 by s plus 1 by t. So we have to further, we have to individually apply Laplace inverse transform for 1 by s minus Laplace inverse of 1 by s plus 1 by t. So now we know, therefore c of t equal to 1 minus, we know Laplace transform of 1 by s plus a equal to e power minus a into t. Therefore here s plus 1 by t, therefore e power minus t by t. So now this is the response of system in time domain. So now response of system for unit step is c of t equal to 1 minus e power minus t divided by t. Suppose first step c of t equal to, we have to multiply with a into 1 minus e power minus t by t. So now what we have to do? So we have to take various time, then we have to substitute into this equation. So we will get the values. So we know this is the c of t value. C of t equal to 1 minus e power minus t by t. So now we can take t equal to 0, then t equal to t equal to 2t, t equal to 3t, t equal to 4t, t equal to 5t, finally t equal to infinity. So now we have to substitute. T equal to 0 means, so now here 0, so here also we can substitute 0, we will get e power 0 equal to 1, therefore 1 minus 1, 0. Then t equal to 2t, so now we have to substitute here. For t, if we substitute 2t, we will get, so both t will get cancel each other, we will get e power minus 2. We know e power minus 2 value, we have to substitute and we will get c of t value. Similarly, for t equal to 3t, t equal to 4t, t equal to 5t, t equal to infinity, we have to substitute into this expression, we will get these different values. So now input is unit step, then what will be the output? So we have to plot graph between this time, various time and its various responses. So we will get this response. Now x-axis is time, y-axis is in terms of response. So we know the times here and its corresponding responses also we know. We have to substitute and we have to draw the, we have to plot the graph, we will get this response. For this unit step input, this is the response of first order system for unit step input. So this is the unit step input, it is its response for first order system.